so good to have you here.
It's nice to be here.
Found that in our archives. I was in Nassau. We went out and got these matching suits.
Yeah, you guys look very similar. It's very cool. I never noticed how much you guys look like each other.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
He was the best.
Miss him.
I thought it would be nice to go down to the end of the island.
Where Grandpa was from?
And show you a bit of our family history. Pay a little respects to our elders and our people that came before us. And I think you would get a lot out of it.
She tried to get that food out that plate. She's hungry.
I had no idea what you were gonna do, and I really had no idea that you'd be this hard of a worker.
But I think that's how you raised me, and I think that's how Grandma raised you, and I think that's how Grandpa raised her, you know?
But now you're taking it to the next level. But everyone
has taken it to the next level in
exactly.
their own way, and allowing the person after them to take
Absolutely.
It even further, you know?
And
we all hold each other in that in that way.
And that's the success, really, that you pass it on to the next generation.
Yeah.
And the next generation takes it to a place that the one before did not.
And I love that intention rather than trying to further ourselves.
Yeah. And that was Grandpa's dream.
Yeah.
That was the whole thing. Can you believe that's the house he grew up in?
I'm Sean Edwards, bringing you another episode of On the Set, where we take you behind the scenes on some of Hollywood's biggest movies and TV shows as I introduce you to some of the individuals who make it happen behind the scenes.
Supervising animator Jamal Bradley has graced the big screen with stunning computer animation for over 10 years. You may recognize his animation from films such as Penguins of Madagascar, Tangled, and The Croods. Bradley talks about the bold moves he made to break into the world of animating films.
For me, it was just really hammering down on my work, and it was a point where I wanted to give up. And I was like, yeah, man, I'm not even gonna make it. I mean, I'm dead serious. I want to stop because I was feeling depression. I mean, I was broke. I was working at the Gap, coming home, trying to do animation. And I was just really focused on working. I kind of cut back on my hours at, you know, the clothing store. I'm working hard in the classroom. And the guy that I didn't know saw me working. He got a job out in California. I didn't know that. For some reason, he was in the class the next couple weeks. You know, and he said, hey, you want to come work out in California? And that was just from him seeing me work hard. Somebody's always looking at what you're doing. I don't care where you're working. You work in the supermarket, you better be the best bagger because somebody's always watching. And that's going to lead you to the next thing, in my opinion. Day to day as an animator pretty much entails trying to figure out how to bring whatever character we're working on in the film, or multiple characters in the film, how do we make them come to life, make the audience connect with them, enjoy looking at them, and feel something for them. Usually coming onto a film, you'll have the voice actor set, and you can use them as a jumping point on who the character is. And a lot of times they will film the character. Now I have a face cam that is filming the actor reading his lines, and we get that as a big point of inspiration, the way they deliver. If they name several, I'll go research that actor and really dive into looking at the performance, the different aspects, the way they move, the way they talk, gesticulations. A lot of times I'll act out the performance myself because it may be something really physical, maybe something comedic, it may be something subtle where I have to really get into an emotional beat, and the actor didn't really do that in the booth. Man, you're really pretty much day to day, you're being an actor. I just don't see myself doing anything else. Like.
Thanks for joining me on the set. We'll be back soon with another episode.
Tonight we have a great lineup of some black musicals.
Yeah, and I mean, you're gonna hear a lot of great music. You're gonna hear artists like Louis Armstrong,
Duke Ellington,
Billie Holiday, Lena Horne,
Ethel Waters.
I mean, it's so much great music that we've all heard before, even if we haven't seen these movies.
Absolutely, and there seems to be a through line of like unrequited love, obsession with men over women and vice versa. There's the mammy versus the hot sexy woman.
Yeah.
There's the hot sexy man versus the strong Mandingo-ish type buck.
And the classic Shakespearean, just tragic love stories. Is this lineup that we're gonna see tonight is just packed.
It's amazing.
Stuff.
I'm so excited.
How you doing, man?
What's up, man?
Man, it's good to see you, bro.
As always.
Man, it's rare that we get, you know, black leads in animation films, but we got for Christmas Will Smith, a black lead in animation. Like, how important is that just for people that don't get to see that and see their image reflected in you in this animation?
Now, to me, that's one of the things that has always been important to me in my career, to really push the envelope. Human beings are creatures of example. So when people see that it can be done, then all of a sudden it's, oh, that happened one time, then it could probably happen again. So it's always been really critical and really important to me to appear in roles that aren't necessarily color specific. Right, that there's no reference in the movie to the fact that my character is black. He just is black, and he is the lead in an animation. And I think it works a lot more powerfully in the mind when it just is, and you don't bring any attention to it.
Yeah. Now you're a rapper, an actor, and a leader. But what are you in disguise?
What am I in disguise? I think in disguise I'm a monk. I think if people were to see how I spend my private time, I have discovered silence, and in the last probably year and a half, I literally spend 14 hours a week in total silence, and I'm starting to love. I didn't realize how much time you need to actually think, to just get quiet and just get away from all of the noise to settle yourself down.
The following events do not occur in real time, but they are real funny. Holla.
Riding through the city.
Yeah.
We just be rolling. Riding.
Come on, riding through the city.
Yeah.
Grandma pedals faster than you, and she's only got one leg.
Yeah, but can your granny do this?
Yeah, I'm like Kobe and LeBron. Any given moment, I can turn it on. When I'm riding through the city, we keep it rolling.
Yeah, you know I'm hot like stone. Yo, man, sorry.
Yo, man, sorry? Is that all you gotta say? I think Horace might have to make a dollar holler.
You all of that. Run up, shout it.
Look, Horace, Dallas said he was sorry. Why don't you just drop it?
If you don't get out of my face, little man, the only thing that's gonna get dropped is you.
Oh. Come on, Horace. I mean, pick on somebody your own size. Oops, my bad. There is nobody your size.
You're right. Your boy Jump Change is safe.
Cool. I know we can work this out.
Not so fast, little rapper boy. Your friend is off the hook, but you're still dangling.
And I'm supposed to be scared?
Yeah. Now what you were saying, little boy?
Oh, no. I'm officially scared.
Yeah. Meet me in the quarter 3:10. Be ready to throw down.
Yeah, be ready to throw down.
Who's gonna throw down?
Huh?
Hmm.
What just happened?
I don't know. But can I have your bike and your lunch?
Put your hands together for the Jammies! Here we go! Here we go! Here comes the Jammies! Here we go! Here we go! Here comes the Jammies!
It's Tyler and Alice and Momo. Yeah. Seven and Lala with the Jammies, and we're coming from Ringo.
You know, with a little makeup and some hair extensions, he could pass for a very unattractive girl.
Here, novelist, take my yoga mat and these candles. If you light them and meditate, it'll ease his chakras and draw out all his anger.
And then a coroner would draw a chalk line around his body.
Hmm?
What you need is one of my rocket packs. You could fly right out of here.
I know something even faster. Your feet. Just run.
Man, you can't run from this fool. You gotta stand your ground.
Oh, what? Like you did earlier today?
If you hadn't gotten in the middle and let me handle it, I would have dusted Horace off.
Right. I think it would have been you that would have gotten dusted.
Watch your mouth, Jet Flea.
Who are you calling a Jet Flea? You're the Jet Flea. I'm not Jet Flea. I am brilliant scientist. You don't know who I am? I represent.
Listen
Watch
to me.
Your mouth.
I know it's yellow.
I don't know what I would have done.
Not
you have no idea.
And the shot hair.
I got an idea. All you have to do is go to the nurse's office and act like you're sick. She'll let you go home or watch television or something.
Oh, owie.
Hi, honey. Are you not feeling well?
Mm-mm.
Okay, open your mouth. I'm going to take your temperature. They're buzzing me, sweet cakes. You sit tight. I'll be right back, novel waddy.
That's funny.
That says 3:10.
Work it, girl.
Lala, I can't do this.
Nah, look, it's easy. Just you put one foot in front of the other, roll those hips from side to side.
Dang, Lala. What size are these shoes?
3:10.
Yes, just like that. Perfect.
Now, all you need are my candles. Hey, I know I just had these candles in here.
Oh, you looking for these?
Yes, you see, with the super turbo jetpack, you'll be safe. All systems go.
Safe at last.
Give it one good punch. No, man. Like this. Watch me.
Man, this bag is heavy.
Yeah, it weighs about
310.
Much better than my rocket.
Possible that someone that tiny can be in so many places?
Because there are, say it with me, people.
310!
Of me.
Hey, you. You want to live? Over here.
Where am I? And who are you?
Welcome to the sub. Students underground because of bullies. We were expecting you, novelist.
Expecting me? You know me?
I was in your introduction to the violin class last year.
Shh, don't tell anybody I was in that class. Seamus McIntyre. Yeah, now I remember you. They, said you and your family moved away.
Well, my family didn't, but I did. Now I live down here in the SUV, the sub.
You're down here hiding from a bully?
Yep, same as you. We're all cowards down here.
I'm no coward!
Hey, horse.
Where?
I gotcha! Coward.
Okay, you got me. So who was your bully?
I can't say his name. If I do, he'll show up.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
Come on, let me show you around. Over here, we have our cafeteria. Look at this. Now, who would waste this perfectly good apple?
Oh, man, that's nasty. Do you guys ever leave?
Well, we have absolutely no reason to. We have everything you guys have up top. Just no bullies, or girls, or movies, or video games. Did I mention no parents? Man, I miss my mommy.
Well then, go see her. All you have to do is walk right through that door.
No, I don't miss my mom that much.
Well, I'm not afraid. Look, here, I'll show you how it's done.
Green 10!
Nav is okay. I know, I'm so worried about him, I can barely eat.
Me too.
Seven, how can you stuff your face at a time like this?
What? This is just a snack. I'm almost fasted.
Take 10, Sev. We're worried about Novelist.
Hey, everybody. What's for lunch?
Nav!
Where have you been?
Oh, I've been so worried about you. Did he hit you? Do you have bruises?
I was worried about me, too. I was under the school in this place called the Sub. That's students underground because of bullies. And get this. Their cafeteria is a conveyor belt. They eat all of our leftovers.
Ew!
Where is this place called Sub? I feel like a sub right now.
So, how you doing, Nav? You must be so hungry after all that ducking and dodging.
Yo, let's see if you can duck and dodge these.
Hey, Jammies. Why so angry? I just wanted to stop by and bring your friend a little lunch. Have a nice day. Toodles. Hey, did you see that? He gave me food.
Yeah, and quality stuff too.
Hey, maybe everything is all good now. He didn't even mention
310.
I just lost my appetite.
May I have your attention, please? Will Novelist please report to the office? I repeat, will Novelist please report to the office? Yes, you're in trouble.
You wanted to see me, Principal Cransberry?
Get in here, you little rascal. Hold this rope and don't let go until I tell you to. You know what they say. Know when to hold them, know when to fold them. Now, it was brought to my attention by several of your teachers that you have skipped classes all day. And you know what I say about kids that skip.
Yeah. Those that skippy will be shippy.
That's right. Do you want to be shippy?
Not rippy.
Hey, no mocking! Now for your skipping antics, I send you to a one-week detention effective immediately.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Principal Cransberry. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh,
thank you.
No, the rope. Get it. My neck and my back.
Oh. Sorry, Principal Cransberry.
That's 2 weeks detention. Call Nurse Kelly. Ow.
My old friend Horace. Somebody help me.
You didn't think you could hide out in my world, did you?
This is your world? Man, I thought it'd be much hotter.
Excuse me, Miss Randall. If it's okay with you, Novelist and I would love to volunteer for a little campus beautification. I noticed the quad was quite messy.
No!
Oh, Horace. What a wonderful idea. I can't believe such a civic-minded boy such as yourself could ever get detention.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Let's go, rapper boy. Your time is up.
Hold on there, boy. Let Clondell tell you something. Just listen, don't say nothing. If you don't mix it up now, you're gonna find yourself mixing it up later. Mark my words. There's no way around it, son. You might as well get to it.
But
I said, mix it up!
Oh,
Yo. So, where's your yellow feathered friend? Do I smell chicken? Hey, Seven, why don't you grab a plate of waffle and then extra syrup, and then we put Novelis on that side?
I'm right here. Nav, what are you doing, man? Get out of here!
Yeah. You should have bolted when you could.
Well, like a wise man with a mop once said, boy, if you don't mix it up now, you're gonna mix it up later.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. Who told you that?
You did. Just a while ago, when you were mopping the hallway. You said, if I don't mix it up now, I was gonna have to mix it up later.
No, I did not. Oh, boy. I was talking to my grandson on my Bluetooth. He's at home making gumbo. Dumbo.
Bluetooth? Oh, no. I'm about to be missing a white tooth.
You're right about that.
No, he's not. And neither are you. I want you two boys to stop this nonsense and shake hands. You heard me! There you go. Isn't that better than fighting?
Now, where were we?
Yeah! I was about to!
Somebody help me.
Hey, Horace, according to the international rules for schoolyard fisticuffs, the victim, which is you, Novelist, chooses the form of battle in which to engage. In the words of Tupac, how do you want it?
What rules, fool? So how do you want it? Aikido, Judo, Kendo, or Ghetto?
What about these?
Ah, yeah! Nunchucks! Yeah!
Nah, man, we're gonna have a rap battle to see who's the baddest on the MIC.
Either way, you're gonna end up on the FLO, cause one thing I do better than fighting is rapping. Check it!
Did you see the signs of the weight when you made the mistake? Lemon hair partner, watch your bones collapse when I cry. I'm known as always the great to deliver your fate. I'm the giving the taste that loves to break.
Wait! The words you spit, I don't think you really saying nothing. I think you bluffing, talking all tough and chest out like you really, really gon' do something.
Come on, horse.
Yeah, please stop running. If I don't stand for something, then I stand for nothing. Like my boys from the subs, we gon' stand for something. Like the Jammies,
united,
we gon' stand for something. Divided, we fall.
Come on,
if we don't stand for nothing.
Whoa! You think you kinda clever, boy? What? Get that crowd on your side like you a rebel boy. What? They can't help ya. Cause they'll get crushed too. Need I remind you,
I'm the one that run this
game. Horace, you gon' do what you gon' do. Plus, you gon' say what you gon' say. But
either way,
right here is where we gon' stay. Either we work together, you can crumble like clay.
Yeah.
This battle ends in a tie.
Y'all better show these boys some love and pick up all your trash. Y'all better not leave my quad dirty, heathens.
You're all right with Horace, Novelist. My beef with you is over.
Oops, my bad.
My boy Seamus, who lived down in the sub.
Hey guys!
What's up?
Boy, it sure is nice getting a fresh lunch instead of the usual leftovers.
Yeah, I convinced him to come up top and face his fears.
Yep, it's been a long time. Can't wait to see my mom. I can't believe I let some bully cheat me out of the best years of my life. If I ever see him again, man, I'm gonna...
Hey guys, what's going on?
Oh no, it's him! The bully! Run!
Heiny? You're a bully?
No. Well, not me. I've turned over a new leaf. That was last year. Anyway, only with the kids in advanced classes, but they better recognize.
Thank you.
How y'all doing? Y'all all right?
Come on.
I got two more I want to share. Y'all feel that? The bottom lane, I got a CD too. Matter of fact, I got two CDs. Both of the CDs have the words to the poems inside. Alright? Both of them are hour long, like 15 poems, and I can tell where your scars are just by the way you walk. And every assault that you have endured has ensured your every step. And you are blessed regardless of the animals that have attacked you. And you are pure no matter who has abused you. I know an angel when I see one. And when our kingdom come, it will be you, I, and the Son. And we will be one. We will create children, and our children will create us. Then every night by the light of the moon, I will kiss away your scars, the Abby Lincoln tunes, and I will drink perfume that tastes like you out of a vessel of the waste, like you. Then I will draw our bath water warm so we can soak till our souls are reborn. And you will be safe and secure in my arms, and it will always be this way. See, I can tell where your scars are just by the way you smile. And every night I walk a mile in your shoes, kiss away your tears and compile your blues till we choose to get sexy with Robert Johnson and Bessie Smith. And I will lick every bit from your soul's revelation to your pain's exodus. And when there's nothing left to sip, I will massage the tension from your nakedness and then lift you in the most effortless way so you can just slowly ride all your pain away. See, I can tell where your scars are just by the way you moan. And every moment we spend together, I just want your life to just keep getting better. Just want your nights to just keep getting wetter. Never want the trust in our relationship to sever. Want you to just let your mind go until you're ready for handcuffs, candle wax, and blindfolds. I want you to feel me inside of you until time slows. And learn to come so hard to be like your spine froze. And then sleep with your eyes closed with a smile on your face until the sunshine shows. See, it will always be like this. And I can tell where your scars are because I was born to kiss them away and make love to you the way that you know that you deserve to be made love to. And you can judge by the way that I hug you so firmly that all your inner muscles work to push more of my trouble along your thighs.
What?
And I massage your neck until your entire body gets so wet that you begin to feel sweat build up along your back and water in your eyes. And the way that you know that it's right is when your nipples become harder than your life is. And your blouse comes undone. And we begin to transfer energy slowly back and forth between your breast and my tongue, and your knees get numb and stomach muscles succumb, and you close your eyes like you ain't never closed them for no one. And ain't nothing wrong if you feel the urge to come while your pants are still on. I mean, you ain't gotta impress me, just be yourself and loosen your belt and slide out of those wet pants and have another sip of rum and fruit juices like we're in the Bahamas. But the truth is, this is the best place to be on earth right now. And after I undress and lay down, I'm going to whisper poems in your ear at frequencies so beautiful that only your clitoris can hear. So if y'all want to hear the rest of the poem, make sure y'all get a copy.
Welcome to Rewrote Review. I'm Nikki.
And I'm Brian, and this is the show where each week we're bringing you the hottest stories in music, movies, TV, and all the things you want to know about right now.
And here's what we've got for you.
Kendrick Lamar's new surprise album is killing it with throwaway tracks.
Eminem goes old school.
Old school.
Really, really old school. Like Sony Walkman old school.
Like Arsenio Hall still in movies old school. Disney's Zootopia is crushing it in the box office.
And celebrities help out with the Flint, Michigan water crisis.
But first, we're going to go to the tragic bankroll fresh story coming out of Atlanta. Police still have no clues and no leads as to the motive as to why people killed the up-and-coming rap star and 2 Chainz protege.
Here's what we know. Fox 5 in Atlanta reported that around 11 p.m. on Friday, March 4th, 50 shots rang outside the Street Exec studio. Bankroll Fresh was fatally wounded on the scene. Now, our Atlanta sources are telling us that first a fight broke out inside the studio, but we don't know who was involved. The internet is on fire.
Oh, it's wild.
So people are saying that allegedly a gun was stolen inside the studio from Fresh, which caused him to chase ATL rapper Scully outside the studio onto the streets, who's also known as No Pluck. That's where Atlanta police are saying that he was fatally wounded.
You know, to me, this sounds like a little bit more than speculation, you know? I mean, people have taken to social media writing open letters saying what happened, who was there, why, all these things, but nobody's actually come forward. Now, it is a hip-hop code violation to go snitching, but until somebody talks to the police, it looks like nothing's gonna get done. So we urge you, if you do know anything about the shooting, please talk to the Atlanta PD.
Yes, please, say something if you know something. So friends like 2 Chainz, Lil Wayne, and Pusha T all took to social media to mourn the loss of Bankroll Fresh. Now, while Bankroll Fresh had the streets lit off of his mixtape, Life as a Hot Boy.
He was an actor.
He was also a breakout actor. He was in 2 Chainz' original series, Take Over Your Trap. But the crazy thing is the murder of Bankroll Fresh is just one of many murders that are plaguing the ATL hip hop scene.
It's been happening like crazy. This is the 4th one.
Exactly. We have Dobie,
Peanut,
Troop, all been fatally wounded, killed, shot in the last year.
It's wild. What's happening down there in the Southeast?
I know. What's going on in the A? I mean, can we just get back to like leaning and rocking?
I hope that we can. On the lighter side of music news, Kendrick Lamar's new surprise album is doing wild things. For more information on that, we're going to music news with our own Andrea.
Don't father a motherfucking do. Are you ready? So right now, stand up on your feet. Come on, get up, LA. Stand up, motherfuckers. Stand up. Because coming to the stage is my motherfucker. He needs no introduction. Start clapping right now. Please put your hands together for the infamous Mike Epps.
Oh, that's what y'all niggas wanna do anyway, dance. Let me play a little bit. That's how the little old nigga be dancing at the club. There it is, goddamn. Play the music again, Chuck E. Cheese DJ. This nigga do Chuck E. Cheese parties, man. Play the music again. Y'all niggas are stiff in here. Some of y'all niggas on them pills.
I go on and on.
Can't stack a bitch good all day long, huh?
I just have superpowers.
Cut it off. What? Goddamn, what's happening, niggas? This club is ran by a lot of trap money tonight. Every nigga got in here on some dope money tonight. You fucking motherfuckers. Some of that money's marked. It's all kind of shit in here. Lady Gaga in the house. Talk, talk, the face. All the ladies who got a bald pussy scream. This bitch did scream. She looked like Snoop Dogg between the legs. Hair everywhere. One more time for Bubba Loke, y'all. One more time. Bubba Loke. He could have been breaking in your house tonight, but I brought him here. Make sure y'all stop taking pictures with them Boost Mobiles. That's a Boost Mobile right there. There's a lot of fine ladies in the house, and there's a lot of booger wolves in this motherfucker too. I seen a couple Project Power Rangers over at the bar. Bitch, no, she ain't got no business in here looking like that. Flavor Flav in the face. I got this Gregory Hines jacket on, fuck y'all. Don't shake your fucking head like I'm telling the truth. You know it's a nigga in here right now with a hand like this. Trying to fill on somebody's pussy. Baby! And you know I wanna love you! bitches don't know his hand is like that because nigga asked for the number on this side. Let me get your number. As soon as you get your number, I'll call you later on tonight, baby. Bitch, get my number back! Give it up for the other comics y'all seen here tonight. Squancho, Little G. These are niggas that Hollywood will not fuck with. They are scared something bad will happen. It's a lot of old players in the house. I know I'm gonna get to buy Cialis tonight. I took two bags the other night and the bitch stood me up. Bitch called and said, I ain't gonna make it. I said, I ain't either. I said, you better get over it. I'm gonna fuck this couch. I can't stand a nigga with funky breath. If I can smell it, I know you taste it. Nigga, you need a Listerine Slurpee. Immediately. A Tic Tac with a battery in it. This is a real crowd right here. Y'all, there's some niggas in here that don't never come out. That's why they ain't laughing. Niggas been sitting in NA meetings all they goddamn life. It's a lot of Big Mama. Hey, Big Mama, how you doing, baby? You look good. You got them little lips. I like a lady with a little lips to make your dick look bigger when they suck the motherfucker. I seen a bitch walking the other day, walking a dog. I said, that's a nice pig. She said, that's a dog. I said, I was talking to the dog, bitch. We got a lot of players in the house. We got a lot of gang members in here that is reformed. But in their mind, they still 20. They got all kind of dusty pistols hid out in the bushes. It's a lot of niggas in here tonight, goddammit. This is the All-Star Kickoff. One more time for LT Hutton, y'all. LT Hutton. A little boss. One more time for LT Hutton. Y'all ladies, stop putting them tattoos all over your motherfucking body. You're gonna be 70 years old one day with a fat, soggy titty with a rose on it. Rose dead on the titty. Put some water on it. Water ain't gonna help that titty. My baby mama had a tiger right here. When she first got him, he was young and rah! I seen him about a month ago, he done slid down this bitch's leg. Nigga like, wow. The tiger's on this bitch's calf now. The tiger is hanging on the stretch mark. Nigga holding on the stretch mark like this. The tiger look like Wendy Williams. How you doing? I seen a couple old niggas I used to snort cocaine with stay away from me. I had the shit as soon as I seen them. Look at the coke heads, they can relate to that. One on one. It's a lot of big girls in the house, like old boy said, it is a lot of big girls in the house. I'm going to Rick Ross shit, that's how Rick Ross loves to talk about food. Triple cheese, lettuce, tomatoes, sitting in the back of my Maybach eating a turkey burger. This candy bar is so magnificent. Nicki Minaj, this bitch is on coffee. This bitch got Tourette's. What's up, man? I wanna call you later on. I'm a motherfucker. Hit him. I said, you better calm down, little pinkhead bitch. I see there's a couple old ladies in here. I'm gonna try to knock them tonight. Get some of that old Patti LaBelle money. Them old bitches is paying. Fuck what you're talking about. You can come in any time of the night on the old bitch. Your food down there in the microwave. Them old bitches buy your shit like lawnmowers. I got you a new lawnmower. I want a Sean John bat jacket, bitch. I don't want no lawnmower. I love smoking weed, but I don't like smoking it with a nigga who don't have none. Every time I fire my shit up, here come a nigga that don't ever have none. That smell good. I dropped my weed the other day and a nigga picked it up and hit it on the way up. Nigga said, here you go, man. Drop your shit, player. I said, nigga, don't hit my shit on the way up and giving it to me. It's a lot of snitches in here, too. We don't know it, but I see a glow on some of these niggas' head. First 48. Them are some ratatouille-ass niggas on that show. It be the hardest niggas on there. What happened the night Poo-Poo got shot? I don't know shit. Get my lawyer. Get out my face. They come back 5 minutes later, nigga head down like this. When they come back from a commercial, nigga got a cigarette and some Popeyes. I seen him shoot 3 people. This nigga done told for a 3-piece and a biscuit. All the niggas with good weed is going home right now. Niggas that got good weed, them niggas act like they better than the niggas who don't. If you call a nigga with good weed at a certain time of night, that nigga, man, I ain't even coming out tonight. I ain't even doing nothing, man. I'll probably call you when I drop my kids off. What kind of fucking nigga is that? I see it's a couple niggas just came home from prison. Let me take you down to Rasul's. I mean, Farouk. Ms. Lynn. It's a lot of gonorrhea in here too, fellas. Don't get burnt on the All-Star weekend. Be on that penicillin by Monday.
Oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire. Yes, homegirl here participating in a very homemade twerk-off where she winds up winning, and it was definitely getting hot in there. I know black people like a fish fry, but damn. And you know, she did say that pussy was fire. What's good, y'all? Welcome to TMI, the show bringing you a little too much information about some of your favorite topics from around the web. What's good? I'm Dylan here in the Revolt Live studio in Hollywood, California. And today, we got a very special guest. Let's say what's up to Miss Karrueche Tran. What's up?
Hey guys. Hey Dylan, how are you?
Good. Thank you for being here. You're so busy lately.
I know. Busy is good.
Very good. What you got going on right now?
Well, I actually have a movie coming out on April 1st called A Weekend with the Family, and it's a romantic comedy, and it is hilarious.
Yeah, Oscars, we're coming for you. Let's get into the show. You ready to get down on some of these vids?
Let's do it.
Over in Cincinnati, Bad Girl Riri's world tour, she gave fan love a new meaning. You know how artists sometimes pretend like they forget the words, so they need some fan help. Homie here, Tara J, we could just give him a big ol' yes. Whoa, so real talk, Karrueche, here's a fan in real life that blows Rihanna away, is all over the web. What's his chances now to actually like make a career for himself?
Honestly, with social media and Instagram, you never know. So maybe some A&R or some labels not gonna look to him, because I saw this clip and he actually has a really good
right?
voice.
He's a lifetime choir boy and Rihanna super fan. It's literally like his dream came true. It really
right.
happened for
hey,
him.
Hey, you never know. Good luck to him.
What about some fan love moments that have happened with you? Anything stand out that are like little beyond the norm? Probably every day something new.
not necessarily.
How many selfies on average are people asking for? To take with you?
Oh, quite a few. And they always say, can we do the duck lips? I'm like, okay.
You know what's the thing about duck lips though? Like, it's silly, but it works.
Everybody, but it's cute. Girls look good. I mean, at least you look cute.
Girls look great. Now, this one is just, this is cute alert. We got Future Junior, Sierra's baby, just making all of us look bad for driving a nicer car than all of us in his G-Wagon.
Driving, Juicy Man?
He's stunned on him.
Yes, I mean, he's barely two and he's already swerving. Careful! Ah! Now, when this video ended, actually, just for being black, he was pulled over and given a ticket for driving a car too nice.
Karrueche
likes that joke. But here's my question. You know, motherly, you know, we all might have kids one day, maybe not. And Russell and Sierra, they just got engaged. Now, Russell has the opportunity to be this man's kind of like stay-at-home dad. Does it bother him at all, you think, that his name is Future?
No, I mean, that's something he can't control. That was a previous situation. And they seem so happy and so great. And he obviously seems to support baby Future and Sierra.
So it's completely irrelevant.
Yeah, no, I don't think that bothers him
cool.
at all.
It's probably like his own inside joke. It's like, my future is now. It's here in the house. And finally, Justin Bieber, currently on his Purpose World Tour, posted this Throwback Thursday with him and Selena back when they were young and in love with the caption, Feels. Now, at what point does your ex-boyfriend become like stalker status? I don't know. If you were inside the mind of Justin Bieber right here, what do you think he was going through now? Karrueche, being someone that may or may not be familiar with a scenario similar to this, I don't know where, you may have dated somebody in the public figure, pop star turned a little urban. And if he were to post a photo of y'all kissing like this, how would you feel? Would you be flattered or does he get more of like a chill, bro?
I mean, if that's how he feels, do you?
Word. I mean, maybe even like it's name not... dropping you in a song or something like that.
Too. I mean, it ain't gonna affect me, but you know, if that's what you wanna do.
For sure.
Okay.
I mean, you can't help it.
I can't
people
help
like,
the, way, the way people feel, I guess.
I know, for sure. So here's the good news. If you love Karrueche, she will always give you a little bit of chance to come back.
Huh?
Exactly.
Okay.
Thank you.
Don't start.
Thank you, Karrueche. And with that, that is TMI. Let's thank Karrueche Tran for being here. Thanks, homegirl.
Thank you for having me.
What are we doing April 1st?
April 1st, we are watching A Weekend with the Family, so make sure you guys are there too.
That's definitely right. Now, are we going to see you on TV too? Maybe a little America's Next Top Model judging?
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed.
Say a prayer for me, please.
Say a little prayer for you. Say a little
Thank
prayer.
Thank you.
And in a very relevant fact, did you guys know that female kangaroos have 3 vaginas? Hey, that is TMI. Peace, y'all. Later. Good stuff, man. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me. I like your hair.
Thank you.
You're gonna get Chris in too, and Peter. Yo, so we here at LA Fashion Week. Can we talk to y'all? I've been out here doing it up. You looking good. You're not talking to the camera today. You looking good. I mean, come on, you got the fashion going on. Everybody, you know, you now iconic up in the community. Just tell people what's going on for the fashion. Tell them about the show, the swimsuits. You gonna be rocking any of that?
We'll both be rocking.
Christina, that's the line to come out with. I mean, tell us what you've seen different with this stuff that y'all seen LA Fashion Week 2012 that you haven't seen on the runway before. I mean, I seen some little designs, but I'm a man. I don't know. Y'all could articulate it a little better for me.
We're trying to ask positive questions.
I know.
Not coming for no nothing grimy. Just give us some good.
I'm trying to think. I don't know. I've seen everything that I've seen all that before. Except
I didn't see that heel thing. You seen the girl with the heel? It was like not all the way here.
And it couldn't. What do you? The heel?
It was like a heel that wasn't all the way to the.
You didn't catch that? Come on, I don't know this fashion stuff. Don't make me look like I'm good.
Get the mic in. Get the mic in.
Come on, just tell me what I saw. I don't know this
I saw a lot of glitter, a lot of glam, a lot of beautiful. Yes, cute cuts. Very low rise. Pubic hair, but it's fine.
I didn't see it. You saw some pubic?
I did too.
Did you get that on the camera?
But it was great. I loved it.
So what's your fashion style? Tell me your fashion sense. I mean, I see you looking sleek and all like cat women, not the tight cat women sit, but all like,
no. Comfortable. Opposite of cat women.
Opposite of cat women?
Yeah.
But you threw it off with the little yellow. It's like you didn't say I'll be all black. You said I'm going to give them a little sunshine.
A little bit of color.
Okay. And you, I mean, you got some heel. I thought you were 6 feet, but your heels are 6 feet. So what's your thing got going on?
I like to be tall, and I like to wear dark colors and black.
Well, thank you, ladies. I mean, we hanging out with y'all Fashion Week. We ain't gonna go there. We just having a good time talking about how y'all look. Cameras want to see y'all. I just had to bring y'all to the world because BlackTree TV want to see Karrueche and tell me your name again.
Tanea.
Looking good out here. So thank y'all.
This is when Beanie Siegel had a beef with Jay-Z. That was like when Twitter first started, and I remember seeing all these tweets about Beanie Siegel dissing Jay. The first tweet I saw was from Fabulous, and Fabulous was like, y'all never thought I'd see the day when Beanie Siegel dissed Jay-Z, and I was like, what? And then K-Slay had played the record, so I heard it, and I was like, oh, shoot. I'm like, yo, I just reached out to a couple people I knew in Philly, like, yo, I gotta get Beanie Siegel on the phone this morning. And he called up, and he just kind of like, Ed J out for like 30, 40 minutes.
So where did this whole situation stem from? Because I'm going to be honest with you,
Beans. The whole situation did stem from, like, I got the Young Gun calling my phone because Jay-Z's only paying them $1,200 a show when they had to split it at the end of the day. Like,
I'll never forget it because that Monday, I was supposed to move into my new townhouse in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. Me and my wife had already packed up everything. The apartment was clean. I had clothes and stuff in my car. I already had put down the security deposit. And that Beanie Siegel interview played on that Thursday, went viral that Thursday night, played it back Friday morning. Saturday was Halloween. Monday come into work. Boogie D, who was the program director at the time, called me in the office and was like, we're moving in another direction. But I remember tweeting out that I got fired after 6-7 months of being at 100.3 The Beat, and all the blogs started running with, did Jay-Z get Charlamagne Tha God fired? And I was like, wow. Because it reminded me of when they said Puffy got Wendy fired. And I remember I did an interview with Vlad TV that same week. And you can go look it up right now on YouTube. And I said on that interview, like, you know, I don't know if Jay-Z got me fired or not, but this is going to read very well in a book one day.
Your name is D22. Memphis, D55, Nassau, Bahamas, D60K.
There's something about traveling to a forbidden country that reminds me of a rebellious child daring to venture beyond the boundaries set by his concerned mother.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Watch your head, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Within that rebellion, which is driven by curiosity, lies something waiting to be discovered, something that isn't immediately or readily available to everyone, but only those who dare to tap into the intuition of their own will to go further.
You secure a newspaper and I print on.
I now invite all you thrill seekers and travel enthusiasts along on my journey as I travel to the country of Cuba. A mere 90 miles off the coast of Florida, lies an island with some of the most kind-hearted and loving people you may ever encounter. Getting ready to head out to, I'm trying to go to the beach, man. I have a friend of mine who I met a second ago. I already forget her name, but hello. My friend is waiting for me. Let me adjust these white balance settings. Okay, now while I adjust these white balance settings, let me just give you a warning. This was my first day in Cuba, and my Spanish was horrendous on my first day. But gradually, as my trip progressed, my George Washington High School Education Spanish class from San Francisco started to kick in. So as I was saying, my friend is waiting for me. She's a nice girl. Hopefully she's not trying to take me for my money, because she has a shirt on that says, get over. And I'm not sure how to feel about that, but I don't think she knows what it means. But in America, if somebody says get over, that means they're a scam artist or they're trying to get over on you. So hopefully she's not trying to get over on me. There she is over there. She doesn't want to be on camera. She actually already told me that she wants $100 if she wants me to charge to pay her. Hola.
Hola.
Sí, es mi cámara.
Ah, Karina, Sony.
Canon. ¿Te gusta?
Una de las mejores.
¿Ah?
Una de las migliori, de las mejores.
Sí. So ahora necesitamos
almorzar.
¿Comida?
Sí, sí.
Y
ahora podemos ir pero a muchos lugares donde ir.
Pero hay comida en, a la Floridita.
Sí,
sí.
Claro, hay comida.
Okay, so necesitas coche.
Claro.
Aquí. It was at this moment that the adventure began. You see, my new friend here, Clyde, she had a dual citizenship from Cuba and Rome, so she was educated. She was well off, and she knew the city like the back of her hand.
Hacen cócteles de, Bueno, tú me invitas a mí, ¿no?
Yeah.
Bueno, tengo dinero. Hacen cócteles de, ¿conoces el daiquiri?
Kiri.
Daiquiri. El daiquiri.
Daiquiri.
Es la bebida de Ernest Hemingway.
Ernest Hemingway?
Yeah.
What you know about Ernest Hemingway?
Pescador.
Okay, so I gotta admit, I was really caught off guard by her knowledge of Ernest Hemingway.
Pescador.
I later found out that the author Ernest Hemingway became a fixture of Havana, and he actually stayed in the country a lot longer than many Americans chose to after the relations between Cuba and the United States began to deteriorate.
O posible. Si yo compro un coche para la día. Es mejor, ¿no?
Sí.
Porque un taxi.
Ah, conviene. Vale.
¿A dónde es el coche?
¿Aquí? No.
Sí, I'll show you.
Yeah, bueno. Porque es mejor, ¿no?
So my thinking here I thought was pretty logical. Rent a car, save money on taxis, and have this local girl who knows all about the city show me where to go. Seems simple, right?
Es el Berkeley Fly. Este para.
So I told her I want to rent a car. I think it'll save money on taxis. Es mejor.
Un taxi?
Sí. No. Sí, es mejor.
You wanna ask her?
Sí.
For how many days? 3 days, 4 days?
Depends on the price.
Hola.
Buena.
Okay. Oh.
So we didn't get the rental car right away. But after a couple of bike rides or hopping on the back of bikes, we were able to finally find a rental car place that had decent prices. It'd be kind of funny, but finding a place that actually had rental cars was almost more difficult than finding an actual flight to Cuba. All I did was book a flight from LAX to Nassau, Bahamas, walked right over to Cubana Air, which is a Cuban-owned airlines, and next thing I knew, I was on a one-way trip to Cuba. There's a joy within the Cuban people that might just be one of a kind. The sounds of upbeat music, smells of flavorful food, and sultry sights of dance are all tossed into one big pot of expression, creating one of the most potent recipes for an enriching explosion of flavor to ever meet your palate.
You can wait for
a la izquierda.
You can wait here or come with me. A minute. You see, basically you can take some picture.
Not long after dropping off my friend Clyde, I followed her direction and headed towards Habana Vieja, or Old Havana, which is supposedly, for a photographer like me, a dream location. Check out some of my shots. I've never in my life been surrounded by such an aesthetically pleasing environment, where every direction I turned, I saw a new photo. Cuba is all about the people, and getting to know them and immersing yourself amongst their culture is what makes this trip a special one. After exploring many nooks and crannies in Habana Viejo, I found myself in a local market where I met a visual artist named Milton. He ended up showing me some of his artwork. He also talked about life in Cuba, traveling the world, and meeting people along the way.
The idea of the Cuba. Cuba is, or maybe the life, but more in Cuba. Today we are here, and you need to jump like this. Tomorrow. You need to jump. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow, you need to jump. Mm-hmm. It's my life. I am energy prepared today for tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow I know that I need to.
Yeah.
It's my life.
Sí.
All the time.
Todavía.
In Mexico, when I was in Mexico, I was invited for 2 girls. When I was in Mexico, first I was in Canada. Excellent. My friends are like my family now. After I visit Mexico, the first month, perfect. In the house of this person. One day in the house, in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, Milton, I don't like that, you stay here more. Why?
Mm.
I need to stay alone, go out of the house.
Mm.
No money.
Wow.
With my big camera, with my laptop, I use a Macintosh.
Oh, wow.
To the street.
In Mexico.
Mexico.
Wow. Peligroso.
Yeah.
Sí.
I must sleep. I am all the time nervous and I meet people. 9 months.
9 months.
In Mexico.
Wow.
I lose the permission to stay in Cuba again. I need to renovate the crazy, but good.
Yeah.
Because I can talk.
Experience.
And now,
yeah.
I am the owner here. In Mexico, I selling this apart. I need to work the drive a car and the owner.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
No, I like to this. No, it's like I say that this is not like this.
Yeah.
I receive experience.
Yeah.
9 months.
And now you're your own boss, and you do what you want.
Yes. I am very happy because I live with my girl, my wife.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in the house, it's the gallery. I work in my wife's helmet. Quiet.
Yeah.
I work in here Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday.
Bastard.
Perfect.
I ended up talking with Milton for about an hour. After we spoke, I was craving more adventure and culture, so I got lost in a small neighborhood where I ended up stumbling across 2 teenage girls who were serving ice cream. It wasn't your typical ice cream shop. In fact, it was quite the opposite.
¿Tienes salado? Chocolate. ¿Cuánto cuesta?
El batería 5 y el vaso de 9 a 3. Jordan, ponme la canción que te dije. Dale, mijo. Ay, cómo me gusta. Jordan, no la quince.
Ya, dale, que es una sola. ¿Qué te pasa? Vamos a hacerlo, papi. Vamos a hacerlo.
Pero ven acá.
Dale, déjalo.
Ay, yo pensaba.
Yo quiero un chocolate. ¿Cuántos necesitas?
Un banquillo.
Sí.
Yeah.
¿Está bien? No, no, yo quiero chocolate de helado. ¿Cuántos cuestas?
Un banquillo de chocolate.
Sí.
Ya, yeah, 5, 26.
¿Necesita más?
No, ya.
Muchas gracias. ¿Cuál es su favorito?
¿Eh?
¿Chocolate? ¿Cuál es su favorito?
¿Cuál es tu favorito?
Favorita. ¿Ah?
Chocolate.
¿Te conozco a la calle de Lugareño?
¿Eh?
Lugareño. Una calle de Lugareño.
Lugareño.
Allá. No sé. Una calle de Lugareño. Lugareño.
Lugareño.
Lugareño.
No, no sé.
Yo quiero este también en la cup. ¿Cómo se dice?
Un vaso.
Sí, yo quiero uno más.
¿Ah? Brasileño.
¿Brasileño?
¿Tú?
No. Estados Unidos.
Ah, bueno.
No me gusta la chocolate.
Escucho, dime.
No. ¿Cuántos más?
¿Tú quieres un vaso ahora? Nueve.
¿No?
Nueve.
No. Necesita más.
¿Que necesito más?
Y sí.
De nuevo de tres. Hay de nueve, de dos bolas y de tres. De tres. Amor mío.
Solo uno. Solo uno.
Sí.
Okay.
Yo no sé de esa manera. Ay, qué.
Qué es chistoso yo. You not laugh at me. ¿Qué es chistoso? ¿Es chistoso?
No, no, no.
No. ¿Es él? ¿Es tu hermano?
Sí, mi hermano.
Ok.
¿Qué te pongo?
Chocolate.
¿Un maquillo aquí?
No, money.
Ay, ay,
no, solo jalado aquí por nueve. ¿Cuántos pesos?
Aquí tienes cinco.
Sí, bueno. ¿Solo nueve?
Son nueve. Te faltarían cuatro.
¿Necesitas más?
Sí.
¿Cuatro más?
Esos son cinco.
Cook. ¿Esos son cook?
Sí, cinco cook. Son cinco pesos cubanos.
Ay, 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 yo estoy listo.
Ay, qué cómico.
Ay, ay, ay.
¿Qué te están pidiendo?
No estoy cámico, no estoy cámico. No.
No, ningún país, no estoy para hablar inglés.
Es mucho. ¿Qué es chistoso? No es chistoso. Tienes una basura porque no quiero esto.
¿Qué?
No, no me gusta.
Vaya, vaya, vaya.
¿A dónde es la calle para el autobús?
Three months.
¿Cuántas calles?
Como dos cuadras.
¿Cuatro?
Dos.
Uno.
Bye.
Bye.
When traveling to a foreign country and venturing off onto unknown streets and territories, it's important that you always maintain your sense of direction. As I continued to explore the neighborhood, I couldn't help but notice that none of the streets were really straight. They all ended up curving and going different directions, and it's very easy to get lost and confused as to which way is the right way. So I do like any tourist does, and I started asking questions to the locals about a street by the name of Lugareño. And to my luck, nobody seemed to know where Lugareño Street was, or had they ever even heard of it.
Is it the calle de Lugareño? No conozco. Permiso. Te conozco a donde es el calle de Lugareño. Huh? Arriba.
Mira, para la calle Lugareño.
Calle de Lugareño.
¿Cuál? Lugareño.
Sí, es una calle posible 5 minutos, pero no sé.
¿Qué pasa?
Necesito ir al Lugareño. Es
Pero no te dijeron qué lugar de La Habana.
Sí, es en La Habana, pero es posible 5 minutos caminando. Lugareño. No sé. Ok. 5 minutos caminando. ¿A dónde es el malecón? ¿Allá?
Malecón. No, allá. Allá, pero es que en malecón no hay Lugareño. Yo estoy aquí.
Malecón es no. That way.
Agua
este.
El P8 y te deja en el malecón.
¿Malecón este, güey?
Y la 16 te deja en el malecón. Shit.
¿A dónde es el Capitolio?
Para allá, tiene que ir para allá. Mira, va como una, dos, sí, tres, una guagua.
Como 7, 8 cuadras.
7, 8.
Para
arriba,
para llegar al malecón, lo que le falta
un...
No, al Capitolio, como 7, 8 cuadras.
El Capitolio, por lo menos 10 cuadras.
Ok.
Coge el P8.
Muchas gracias, muchas gracias.
Ok. I eventually found Lugareño Street and ended up meeting my new friend Clyde at a local Cuban restaurant that was serving traditional cuisine.
Ok. Tengo hambre.
Te y yo. Te
mucho
te...
hambre, mucho.
Hombre, oh, sí. Mm.
Yeah.
Ay, arroz, frijoles, siempre es típico. Claro. Con la música cubana.
Jugo. Sí, para ventana. Sí. Posible. ¿Me miro? Perfecto.
Manu, dos aquí. Arriba. Sí, usted, dígame.
Muchas gracias.
¿Ya?
Sí.
Listen to the the authentic song of Guantanamera as we waited for our food to arrive. I enjoyed soft bread, along with rice and beans that had a sweet flavor to it that I just couldn't resist. No matter your destination of choice, whether it be Cuba or some other far-off land, I encourage you to step out of your comfort zone and dare to live in the moment. Capture your dreams and help preserve the memories of a lifetime to cherish and to share with loved ones and strangers we meet along the way. Until next time, thanks for watching.
Cuba, they don't have basketball, so we play with coconuts.
So I done research and, you know, I learned, you know, the different levels of participation as far as equity is concerned between an artist and a record label. So I go in there and he sits down and he talks to me. He say, man, I really love, you know, the response, man. It just came out of nowhere. It just came, you know, and people just started. I'm like, no, it was not out of nowhere. There was some significant effort put into this. And my basically what my spiel was to him, okay, so since my album dropped, and it probably was about 4 to 6 months between the time it was released to the time he actually heard the buzz. So I was like, man, since my album dropped, you know, I have been tirelessly investing in myself and basically operating as an independent record label. So for me to move forward, there would be absolutely no way I would see it reasonable for me to operate as an independent label and not get the credit for being an independent label. I said, because if I was just waiting on y'all, you'd have never called, mm-hmm. and I'd have never been here. So for me to work on the second album to ensure that it won't turn out the way the first one did, I'm gonna need $2 million in a joint venture. And he said, that's it? I say, yeah, that's it. And he say, oh, what? I say, oh, you can just let me go. He say, okay. He say, I tell you what, let's have lunch. You know, let's have lunch. He meant separately. He didn't mean together. He meant, you go and get you something to eat. I'm going to stay here, dude. And we'll talk again after lunch. So I'm like, okay, all right, cool. So, you know what I'm saying? I went out, got me and Jay went and got us a couple slices of pizza. And you know what I'm saying? You know, we came back about 30 minutes to an hour later, and we sitting in the waiting room, and I'm looking at Jason. I'm like, man, it taking them that long? Man, well, it don't take that long to say no. You know, we good, so we in there. We like, man, we finna get $2 million. And so then, I believe it was Mark Pitts who was with LA at the time. And Mark Pitts came out and said, all right, guys, we ready. And then when he walking in, he say, man, you got what you wanted? I say, yeah. So I get in there. I say, okay, what's up? And LA say, man, I'm going to give you what you want. I'm going to let you go. What? Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's right. Let me go. So he turned me loose. But see, you know what I'm saying? What I didn't understand then, he turned me loose into the industry, like with a buzz as a free agent. I already had a song going on the radio. I was already doing shows. So I went and got 2.5 from Atlantic and a JV. You know what I'm saying? So that was the beginning of me building my own label. And you know what I'm saying? I haven't looked back. But that's how I learned how, you know, own your masters and, you know, joint venture versus P&Ds and, you know, all that.
So let me take us to...
Typically, Bloom is someone who is just incredible. He's my Zone 4 local music group label mate, and his show is just incredible. And by popular demand, Timothy Bloom, we would love for you to come out and do an encore of the song Took Me the Time. Yeah. So without further ado, again, Timothy Bloom.
Oh, if I should die tomorrow, oh, please let there be life. Long, no need for sorrow. Let's just make love until morning light. I want you to love me.
And out of all the girls in the world, you, baby. Yeah. Ah.
Is that right?
Could you lean on my legs?
I started playing since I was a little kid, and you know the stars align. They kind of, you know, come to a place, and we all came together and we started writing music together. A majority of the album that we've done so far has been written and produced by me, and the band, we just all came together, you know, recently, and we just started. It's just brotherhood. Like, it's an amazing feeling. So, you know, it's amazing.
How long have you guys known each other?
We've known each other for 4 months.
Are you serious?
Mm-hmm.
So how is that? I mean, how does that work? 4 months?
After a while, I don't know. I mean, the realness of how they came to me and how we just came together, it was just chemistry from day one, and it's just been like that. You know, I wouldn't. You know, they asked me to change out of band, and I'm like, no, I don't want to. Like, these are my brothers, and I love them. You know.
So, nice. Now, who are your musical inspirations coming up?
Growing up, you know. I listen to a lot of country gospel.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Where are you from?
I was born in Texas and traveled around the world. My dad was in the military.
Okay. So tell us about your album. What can the fans expect on your album?
The album is in full bloom, and basically, you know how when you plant a seed, what do? You just, you know, the album is just going to go from, you know, from a seed, and it's going to dynamically grow, you know, and I hope it comes across that way.
Definitely.
You know, so I'm looking forward to it.
Now, it's Grammy week. Do you have any people you're rooting for, any people music you've listened to this year that you really, really like and you want to let us know about?
I don't know how to say this, but for the whole year of last year, I never listened to any radio or anything. I just stayed home for the past year and working on my craft and just getting that prepared. So I just feel honored and privileged to say that whoever, you know, the Grammy week, you know, I'm God bless them in everything that they do, you know, and I think it's awesome because, you know, they're receiving a reward. I'm just going to be chilling at home with the kids, you know.
Yeah.
Just being real cool about it.
Now, I just came back from a panel talking about social media, mm-hmm. Twitter, Facebook, MySpace, not so much anymore, but do you use any of those, and is that how you interact with your fans?
Definitely. Facebook has been a crazy response from, you know, just the single being out right now, and Twitter, you know, you have to continue to do it once people start, you know, they start to, oh my gosh, you know, and you have to answer. You just can't be nonchalant and say, oh, da. You know, and it's just kind of, it's like, it's warming, you know?
Yeah, definitely. You got to stay in there if you want to be relevant. So, mm-hmm. Yeah. Anything you want to tell us about your single coming up before we end this interview?
Until the Time, you know, Timothy Bloom featuring V. Bozeman. And I'm honored and blessed by God to even be in the position that I am. That's all I can say, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Awesome. Thank you very much. You heard it here first.
Hey, what's happening? This is Marlon Wayans, and you are watching BlackTree TV, Soul of the South. You could have been watching White Bush TV, but instead you're watching BlackTree TV. I came up with that.
This is BlackTree on TV, and I'm your host, Alex Hudgens. We are your number one source for urban entertainment. Find out why Marlon Wayans ain't afraid of no ghosts, or jokes, why Morgan Freeman ain't afraid of no technology, and how Janelle Monáe went from Kansas City, Kansas to becoming an international star, and how super producer Will Packer and director Tim Story plan to take over the world with black movies. First, Marlon Wayans continues the family business with his spoof comedy sequel, A Haunted House 2. But why should he be concerned with PETA? He sat down with our Jamal Finkley to explain.
I don't know about this place, baby.
You said that about every house we looked at.
This one's different. I just...
No, this one is perfect.
Come on, Charlotte, Junior. It's like he's scared to come in the house. Call 911! Tell him the dog is white! Tell him the dog is white!
So first, man, you know, Michael Vick is still catching flack from that dog stuff. I see another dog got hurt in this movie. You ever worry about PETA jumping on you, anything about...
You gonna hit me with the Vick? No dogs or animals was harmed during the making of this movie. We actually put that, I think, at the end of the movie. It's a fake dog, man. I wouldn't want that to... And what's sad is I named that dog after my kid's dog. And their kids named their dog after Brad and Angelina Jolie's baby. I don't know why. They just love the name Shiloh. And they're like, it's so cute. And he has blue eyes like Shiloh. And I was like, okay.
Where do you pick? Because I know, like, you have Conjuring and you put other ones in Haunted House. How do you pick which movies you're going to kind of spoof a little bit?
They kind of pick you, man. It's like, if we watch the same movie, you would get something completely different than I get. You know, we just have a sick, twisted mind, and the darkest moments we find light in. It's not like I go out going, I think if you go out going, you gotta do a scene, this popular scene from this movie, I think you're failing it.
Ain't you that brother that just moved into old Burton Place?
Yeah,
and with a white woman.
Well, she's not all the way white.
She's a white woman, damn near clear.
Come on now, it's 2013. Interracial relationships is not a big deal.
What? You need to tell that to the lonely sister. Here, look at this one right here. How to show them how you drop it like it's hot. Woo! Hold up, Bertha. Hold up. We ain't got no defibrillator.
I think that's my cue to go. Excuse me, sister. Have a good sermon.
Where are you going?
Love is love. Love is love. You're so bitter.
See?
You're angry.
Brothers be tripping. That's why I got me a white man at home.
Haunted House, you have this formula. You did $2.5 million budget for the first one.
No, 1.7. I wish I did have 2.5. I could have really used those extra days of shooting. We could have had lunch. If you're able to do and you're able to do it again, then that's the blessing. Money and box office, of course, you want that success.
Yeah.
But just do it because you love it. I am so lying. Yeah, it feels good. Ha! In your face, haters. Ha! Ha! $67 million worldwide in your face.
Can I get a tag before?
In your face! Tag that in your face! You know scrotum's having a show!
Marlon Wayans is a fool. Thanks, Jamal. That was hilarious. Or at least way funnier than technology taking over the world and all of mankind. Yep, that's the premise of Transcendence.
The path to building superintelligence requires us to unlock the most fundamental secrets of the universe.
Intelligent machines will soon allow us to conquer our most intractable challenges.
To develop new methods for the early detection of cancer.
To build a better future for all of us.
Simply put, to save lives.
Once online, its analytical power will be greater than the collective intelligence of every person born in the history of the world.
Professor?
What did you do?
Take out the cores.
Revolutionary independence from technology, RIF.
They hit AI labs all over the country.
We're determined to stop any attempt at what you call transcendence.
We're looking at 5 weeks before a system shuts down.
When I'm gone, keep moving forward.
I won't let you go.
We can upload his consciousness.
We can save him.
Not like this. If we missed anything, how will you know who you're dealing with? Oh my God.
It's like my mind has been set free. I'm gonna need to expand. I need more power. Get me online.
This is no well.
shut it down.
Shut it down? It's him!
Where are you going?
Everywhere.
Your friends? They don't know the danger.
If she connects to the internet, the first thing it'll do is copy it up. And then there is no taking it down.
The real will die. Whatever it is, it's building an army out there.
What is this?
It's evolution.
This isn't evolution. It's an abomination.
What the hell's happening?
I'm able to fix them.
This has gone too far, Will. Stop it!
I don't understand. This is the future.
This is not our future.
Evelyn!
You're not here with me.
You've changed. Have you fallen out of love with me?
No.
Have you?
If we don't stop him, it will be the end of mankind as well.
Whatever we can discover, whatever we can create that might enhance human power of learning, power of doing, power of creation, is a good thing. Until you get there.
Good evening, Donald Buchanan.
It knows me. Of course it does. DMV records, social media.
Penn, tell Agent Buchanan about yourself.
I am Penn, a physically independent neural network invented by Dr. Will Castor.
Can you prove that you are self-aware?
That's a difficult one.
Man, Morgan Freeman was not joking around. That was deep, very deep. Coming up, we catch up with Mary J. Blige to talk about Black Nativity, now on DVD. And we uncover super producer Will Packer and director Tim Story's master plan towards global black movie domination. Plus, find out how Janelle went from Kansas City, Kansas, to R&B superstar, to cover girl, to Hollywood's new It Girl. And we hit the red carpet at the Rio 2 premiere in South Beach. It's all next on BlackTree on TV.
You're watching BlackTree on TV, only on Soul of the South.
Welcome back to BlackTree on TV. I'm your girl, Alex Hudgens, and we are your number one source for urban entertainment. Now, there's no bigger urban entertainment icon than my girl, Mary J. Blige. She talks about some of her favorite collaborations with Jamal Finkley.
Do you guys know the way to Harlem?
Am I the cause of all my mother's misery? Did my very birth destroy my whole family?
Us child, it'll be all right. I'll get you through this side of night.
This ain't living.
No.
I got a mouth to feed, but I can't make these ends meet.
She's struggling. What kind of parents are you?
We're the broken.
So, Mary J, first, thank you for a great performance and for sharing your music with this film. It's always great to see you in this medium as well as listen to you. So
thank
best
you.
Of both worlds.
Thank you.
When you look at Black Nativity, it's going to be one of those Christmas movies that people are going to watch over the holidays with their family. When you think back, is there any movie that you like to watch either then or now over the holidays that you could remember that was big for you over Christmas?
I mean, what's big for me is Christmas cartoons. As a child, I watched Rudolph, I watched Baby New Year, you know, those puppet cartoons. But as an adult and a teenager, it was a Christmas Story, you know, with the Ralphie and the BB gun and you shoot your eye out.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it was funny and it was light, but it was, you know, it was still Christmas, you know?
Yeah. What are some of your favorite collaborations?
Number one on my list is the Method Man and Mary, You're All I Need. I said this to you yesterday.
Yeah, we just didn't have it on camera.
Yeah, okay. Oh, I didn't know we wasn't on camera. The Method Man and Mary, You're All I Need to Get By. Of course, the Jay-Z and Mary, Can't Knock the Hustle.
So with those two great ones, who could we expect coming up? Like, who could be that next great duet that you haven't done yet that you're interested in working with?
You know, I don't know yet. I don't know who that person is yet.
Like I said, Mary J. Blige is my girl. She's been doing her thing for years, dominating the charts and everything with her music. Now, in other domination news, producer Will Packer, you've seen some of his movies, Think Like a Man, Obsession, Stomp the Yard. He's teamed up with director Tim Story, and they plan to dominate the world with black movies. You see what they did with Ride Along, so watch out. Jamal Finkley sat down with the two power players to discuss their strategy.
What's up, little man?
What's up, little man?
What are you talking about? I'm not the little man, you are.
Hey, don't start this if you don't want to finish.
Start what? What you about, 310, 311?
Yeah, but you know what I'm gonna do. Bro, what you gonna do, stretch? I ain't telling you nothing.
What you just did was spit on my lip.
Yeah, I did.
I just got you a little time in prison.
Huh. Man, you're not a cop.
I'm about to make a citizen's arrest.
I make a citizen's arrest too.
For what?
Impersonating the officer.
What?
You said you were a cop. That's illegal.
That is it. This is what I'm gonna do time for. You gotta give out your brother. Give me your brother.
Stranger danger.
What?
Stranger danger. Stranger danger.
Man, let me fix you up.
I don't wanna touch you there. You wanna see my what? I don't wanna see yours.
He's playing.
My mom says this is private.
That's my nephew.
First, great to see y'all reconnecting on another project, another franchise. How cool was it to put Kevin Hart and Ice Cube together on film? How was that?
To me, it was a dream come true. I mean, you know, these guys together, you just knew they were just opposite ends of the spectrum, and just coming together would be like just magic. So
and that's the key with the buddy comedy, you know, having that chemistry, having that juxtaposition between two guys that you can't stop watching, and that's what you get with these two.
What are your plans to kind of like start placing these movies, or do y'all have plans to start getting these movies more of an international appeal?
You know what? I think one of the things that Tim and I both talk about is making films that have universal appeal. And it just so happens that the two leads are African American. But, you know, the script has no color in it at all. And I think the way Tim directed the film was colorblind. So it's a universal story. It's about a guy, you know, and he's in love and he wants to propose and he's got to get the blessing of the brother. And a lot of people can relate to that. So I think that's something that we want to do, is take this film out to international audiences. It's a big push of ours and something that we want to do. And I think it starts with the content.
Up next, Janelle Monáe helps to bring Rio 2 to life with her music. And we meet the other creative forces behind the hot Rio 2 soundtrack. Then we hit the colorful and explosive Rio 2 red, no wait, blue carpet in South Beach. It's all coming up on BlackTree on TV.
You're watching BlackTree on TV, only on Soul of the South.
Hey, welcome back to BlackTree on TV, your number one source for urban entertainment. She's quirky, energetic, and has a voice out of this world. So how did Janelle Monáe go from Kansas City, Kansas, to an international superstar? Our Sean Edwards finds out.
We need something that can make us wiggle.
Hit it!
Something that make us jiggle. We need something that pops. You know what pop is backwards? Pop.
I think incredible music, that's what made Rio so good.
I'll be the first to say welcome back.
He is muy guapo.
What is love if it's not with you?
A lot of percussive elements, a lot of strings, just right. Something that people can just dance to.
Tell me you hear those drums, you know, something fantastic and magical is gonna happen.
You guys are late, clock late, but musician early.
So what's going on, guys?
Hello.
Got my hometown girl in the house, got a living legend in the house, but we're gonna do this proper because I gotta tell you this now. You're gonna get a kick out of this. I gotta tell you this story. All right. It was a while ago. I was like in the business for a couple of years.
Mm-hmm.
So like I needed to like do something creative. So I went to like this poetry slam at the Blue Room on 18th and Vine.
Oh my God.
So I'm at this poetry slam, checking out all these cool creative people do their thing, beautiful poetry, terrific wordplay. So a young lady comes over to the table and she's talking to me. She says, "Hey, aren't you that dude that's like on TV that does like the movie thing?" I'm like, "Yeah, what's going on?" And then she proceeds to tell me, "Well, one day I'm going to be famous too, and you're going to be interviewing me."
Oh my God, did I tell you that?
This was the young lady, yes, in the Blue Room.
Wow.
Yeah, it was like about 2002, 2003.
I can believe it,
yeah,
I'm kidding.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. I'm going to be famous one day, and you will interview me. So it came true, because I'm interviewing you now.
That's so crazy.
Yeah.
Was a time of transition for me, and I probably just moved to Atlanta too, like right after that.
Yeah, you were taking. You told me that too. You're like, I'm out of here.
Yeah, and I said I wanted to start my career as an independent artist, and I lived in a boarding house with six other girls, and I just sold my CDs out my house and just, you know, cultivated a fan base in Atlanta. I didn't care if I had 100 fans. I just wanted to do it on my own terms.
So how'd you get started? Like, what was your big moment where you knew, like I'm going to be a fantastic musician, I'm going to make it work, and I'm going to do my thing? When was that moment? When did it happen for you?
You know, for me, it has been an incredible journey. Mm-hmm. So I feel very blessed and very lucky to still be working and to still be here with a young talent like Jarnell, to be doing the music of Rio. But I started in Brazil. Started as a young kid, 7 years old, learning classical music, and then started playing clubs in Rio.
Nice.
It was a wonderful time because it was like around the, talking about early 60s, the Bossa Nova. It's a great song.
That music is incredible.
So I came to the United States for the first time in 1962. I played at Carnegie Hall with Dizzy Gillespie, Stan Getz, Joe Beam, and I was like, wow.
Yeah, you see, this guy, he needs his own, you need a movie, it's time. You need to do your thing.
Homegirl is mad cool. Love her and her music, and of course, her sense of fashion. Still ahead, we go into the studio with Janelle Monáe and the other musical stars of Rio 2. And we'll take you to the Rio 2 premiere in South Beach. Don't miss it.
You're watching BlackTree on TV, only on Soul of the South.
Welcome back. You're watching BlackTree on TV, your number one source for urban entertainment. Let's hit the studio and hang out with musicians that brought the Rio 2 soundtrack to life.
We're going to scout the wildest, coolest talent in the jungle.
It's our inspiration for this year's carnival show, Amazon Untamed. Next.
What kind of song are you guys looking for?
We need something that can make us wiggle, something that make us jiggle.
Okay. I think I might have the song just for you.
All right. Hit it.
Who is ready for a tropical adventure?
What is love if it's not with you? I know when you're alone, you feel it too. In your arms is where I long to be. 'Cause being with you gives me sanity. Oh, listen to me, darling. I wake up every morning thinking about
you. Oh, yeah, I got it. I'm good.
Yo, this is untapped territory. I'm loving this sound.
What good is love if it's not your love? What good is love if it's not your love? I know you're alone. You got to feel it too.
Place. This is popping. It's popping in the Amazon.
So what do you guys think?
Boom. That's it. You in.
Yes.
You're awesome.
Well, that means we will see you guys at Carnival.
Yeah! All right.
Wait,
Dad, can you hear this?
Wait, we didn't do a head count.
Oh. Hey, guys, wait up. They left without me. Again. That's
now, if you aren't in the mood to dance after that, then I don't know what to tell you. That was hot! Just like the Rio 2 red, actually blue carpet premiere in South Beach.
I like the movie because it appeals to those who want to protect the environment, and it lets the young people know we plant that seed now in them and we can save the trees and all of these things, and I believe in that. So for Carlos, the director, to make me a part of it and ask me to come back was an honor to me.
I was hoping we were going to make another one, and then Carlos reached out and said, we're going to go back, we're going to do it, and this time we're going to the Amazon. And it's the greatest group of people you could ever hope to work with. And I love my character, and it was the easiest yes I've ever said.
It's a very joyous and buoyant film. It's filled with, you know, very touching moments. And it also has, for me, something that's, you know, that I think for all of us is very important. This sort of like thematic of you know, environmental concern.
Well, you know, the cast, I mean, the success of the movie, these kids, you know, man, it's just an amazing event. And this is beautiful. Get the kids come to Miami, went to Rio last time, so this is beautiful.
A good sign is that everybody came back and we added people, you know, Kristen and Andy. But, you know, we've known each other a long time, you know, Jamie Foxx and myself and Will, so, and Andy.
That's it, another hot show. Thanks for watching. Once again, it's been a blast. I'm your girl, Alex Hudgens, and you've been watching BlackTree on TV. If you want more, you can subscribe to BlackTree on TV on YouTube, like us on Facebook, and follow us on Twitter. Lots of exclusives and other hot stuff. That's how we ball out.
You're watching BlackTree on TV. Only on Soul of the South.
Welcome back, y'all. You're watching BlackTree on TV. Like what you've been seeing and want more? Then subscribe to our YouTube channel. We've got exclusives and a ton of interviews with the biggest stars on the planet. Check us out. Meanwhile, it's time to throw it back as Kevin Hart and Eddie Murphy go toe-to-toe. Who's funnier? We can't call it, but maybe you can. Here's how it all went down with our man Jamal Finkley caught right in the middle.
Like every now and then I'd be like, I hear like on some island somewhere, they'd be like, oh, they had the Black so-and-so filmmaker awards, and be like, what? Oh yes, 20 years they've been doing it. I never heard of that. I've been gigging 30 years, what? Oh yes, this year we honored AJ Jamal. And, what?
This is big though. A thousand words I'm here with Eddie Murphy, a man who I
finally we finally get to sit
finally
down.
After 16 years, I finally get to sit down and sit across from you, man.
That's right.
And you were you were the biggest comedians and actors ever in the game. You know, you've had some of the best pictures, and it brings me to this thing that happened not too long ago where Kevin Hart broke your stand-up box office record.
What record did he break?
He said he broke some record of your box office sales and for stand-up.
I don't know. Where did he break? I don't know what he broke.
When
Nobody Raw is still the number one box office concert movie in history, so I don't know what records Nobody broke, Kevin.
Yeah, I broke Eddie's record.
I ain't even been on stage in 27 years. They still trying to break my records. God bless y'all.
When are we, I mean, or are we ever gonna see you on stage again doing stand-up?
I'm gonna do it again, because I got to break Kevin's new record. I got to get back on the stage, because this new record that Kevin got, I got to have it back, Kevin. You ain't keeping this record, whatever one it is. I got to have it back, baby. I love Kevin Hart, by the way, incidentally.
Hilarious. Looks like Eddie Murphy is ready to defend. He went all Game of Thrones on Kevin Hart. I'll see how Kev responds.
Hey, that Lambo okay right there, right?
It's my car.
Let's go. This is your bachelor party.
Next 24 hours, the boys will be with the boys.
And the girls with the girls.
In this battle of the sexes, I was determined to keep us ahead of the girls.
You're rolling with the pros.
Let's go!
Girl, I must. I sense something strange in my mind.
Floyd Money Mayweather!
I mean, Kevin Hart, it's been a huge year for you. You got the 5-year plan, exit strategy, Think Like a Man. Who knows what else you're doing?
I know.
You know what else you're doing. Probably your
what's going on? Just to give you an idea.
I interviewed Eddie Murphy about a week ago. He challenged you. Said he's coming back for that title. I mean, you think you ever do the Laugh at My Pain Raw tour or something like that?
No, man. Here's the thing about Eddie Murphy myself. First of all, he's a good friend of mine. But just for people to understand, there is no catching Eddie Murphy or breaking Eddie Murphy's record. Just the, you know, the media says I broke a record of his and ticket sales for a day. But Eddie Murphy is on a pedestal. The pedestal that he's on allowed me to walk through the doors that I'm walking through now and do what I'm doing. There is no surpassing him or Richard Pryor or Chris Rock. Those men are great. Bill Cosby, I go on and on. I'm a young guy in the game that's coming up following the footsteps of legends. So I'm just trying to be in my own realm. Hopefully one day I can be in the same conversation as those guys.
Yeah, and I just want to say that he is undoubtedly one of the most grateful people I've ever worked with in my life. He is so grateful for those guys as well as being where he is. And it makes it easy to be around him too.
That was fun. Two legends going toe to toe. We've got mad respect for both. This has been another episode, but unfortunately, it's time to say goodbye. For now. If you want more BlackTree on TV, subscribe to the BlackTree TV channel on YouTube. And to catch up on episodes you missed, visit us at ssn.tv. Lots of cool stuff to hold you over until next time. Because you will be back next time, right? I'm Alex Hudgens, and this has been BlackTree on TV, your number one source for urban entertainment, period.
From the Revolt Live studio in Hollywood, California, what's good, fam? I'm Dylan, and this is TMI. Y'all see the hot new couple on the prowl? Rob Kardashian and Blac Chyna. They began all touchy-feely down in Jamaica. Now, his sisters, well, they aren't too happy with the relationship, saying she's in it for the wrong reasons. Now, at what point do your homies let you know, hey, man, she's only in it for the fame? I don't know, probably the same time Rob says, it's all good, I'm only in it for the sex. Woo! And it's probably pretty good looking all fake Nicki Minaj and shit. Pretty even trade. Y'all see this viral video out there? While President Obama was in Chicago casting his vote in the Democratic primary, homegirl Aiyah Cooper, her spot was just blown up by her boyfriend Mike Jones. No, not the rapper.
I really wasn't planning on it.
He walked by and said, Mr. President, don't touch my girlfriend. Now, does this man have a point? Because it was pretty, you know, on the money. Here's the most powerful man in the world. He's pretty good looking, he speaks well, and he balls. Boyfriends of the world, stay on notice. Would you do the same thing? I don't know, just wanna like hang out with Obama. It's pretty cool, man. In porn news, remember back in the day when the Fappening happened where 20 celebrities' nude photos leaked? Well, the guy responsible for it, Ryan Collins, is pleading guilty. That's right, the FBI caught you, man. Can't get away with that shit. Gross. Got sisters out there, man. We got sisters and moms and aunts. Now, he was found guilty of accessing unauthorized computers when hacking into over 100, stealing nude photos from at least 20 celebrities and putting them all over the damn place. Now, Jennifer Lawrence, Kate Upton, Hope Solo. Thank you. No, I'm serious. I didn't even look at them. Did you? Don't lie. Now, he could face up to 5 years in prison for illegally uploading all these private photos. Now, his legal team, though, wants him only to sit behind bars for 18 months. That does not sound like it's enough time. What do you think is the appropriate punishment? Definitely at least 2 or 3 years, man. We'll post your jail photos. You gotta see this story, how LeBron James wants to steal Beyonce from Jay-Z. That apparently is according to Jeff Adrian, former NBA player. I know, who, right? Exactly. Basically, he tweeted at LeBron saying, you know what's funny? Is at King James is from BS Akron, Ohio, thinking he gonna take Beyonce away from Jay-Z. This is endless conversation, folks. First of all, who? Jeff Adrian? You've played for 9 NBA teams and your last team was over in China. So before you come at the great one, chill. Number two, I'm pretty sure every man in the world has said some sort of conversation about getting busy with Beyonce off the court. So the fact that you personally think that LeBron has a chance just shows how much you wanna get with LeBron off the court. And you know, finally, look at this man. Looking like Chris Angel performing magic tricks on the side of the court with your purple hair, anime star. Damn, dude. Get it together, man. Changes to Instagram.
I know, right? Scary.
Basically, have you realized that in the top right corner of Instagram posts, there's no more timestamps, like when you're gonna like that girl's photo from 52 weeks ago, or actually you won't because you don't wanna look like a stalker? Yeah, we see you. Basically, instead of chronologically being posted to Instagram, your best friends and favorite accounts are definitely gonna be on your feed, because Facebook and Instagram, you know, Facebook owns Instagram, they're gonna make sure that you see your favorite posts first with a new algorithm. Is that getting a big love, a big heart from you, or is that a big dislike? Let us know. And finally, the hell is that? Seriously, this is 30,000 feet up in the sky. There's a man that was flying from Austria and he sees this shadowy figure on top of clouds. And now you think it might be fake or whatever, but like there's a shadow and the sun's over there and it's casting that. That's some crazy ass stuff. Aliens, they exist. They're just waiting for us to be ready. And finally, you guys know that urine back in the day was used to whiten teeth. Ew. That is TMI. I'm Dylan. Peace. See you next time.
What can I say? I fell in love with Ecuador. I mean, what's there not to love about this place? As if the countless cascadas that are raging through the Andean jungles, that's waterfalls for all you gringos, as if that's not enough of a reason for you to fly down to South America, then perhaps the iconic stained glass windows or the stone steeples of the city's famed church, La Basilica del Voto Nacional. And if you adrenaline junkies need your fix, there is always a kilometer-long zipline that propels your body over death-defying heights overlooking spiraling rivers. But before you hear about all of that, you could come here for one reason alone. The soup. That's right, the soup alone is worth traveling the 3,000 plus miles. You see, this is no ordinary soup. Here in Ecuador, soups are a symbol of culinary tradition and a very delicious source of comfort food when in the high altitude of the Andean mountain range. Now excuse me while I order my morning juice.
Oh, azúcar y hielo.
Hielo y naranja y fresa.
She pretty much already knew what I wanted because she remembered me from yesterday. I mean, that's how they are here. And I have a feeling if I were to come back a year from now, she would probably remember me then too. Now back to this soup. Sancocho. It's a very popular broth-based soup with hearty foods in it, like yuca, corn, plantain, and perhaps guinea pig. One of my favorites was sopa de yuca. It was a much creamier soup, had various vegetables and white pescado. Delish. When visiting a new country or city, I particularly like to find a vantage point where I'm able to get my sense of direction back after the long flight. To me, it's important to see the layout of the city to best understand my plan going about to see as much as I can in this new foreign land.
Hola, ¿qué pasó? All you travel lovers out there, as you can see, I made it to the top of this beautiful mountain above the city of Quito. Quito lies in the middle of Ecuador, it's the capital city, and I'm on top of the mountain called Cruz de Loma. And I must say that I'm very short of breath because we're 4,100 meters above sea level. So we're like halfway up to where the airplanes are flying right now. But luckily for us, it's not too cold because here in Ecuador, they pretty much get year-round spring-like temperatures. So when you come here to Cruz Loma, you're gonna make sure that you take the teleférico, which is like a cable car that's on a wire. It takes you to the top of the mountain. It's actually kind of scary. If you're afraid of heights, I recommend maybe not looking down. But when you get to the top, it's well worth it, I promise. What's up guys, so I've made it to the city of Baños. It's about 4 hours outside of Quito here in Ecuador. And as soon as I got off the bus, I couldn't help but notice tons of this taking place. Now what it is, it's actually sugarcane that's been processed down and it's made into a caramel. The proper name for it is Melcocha de la Caña de Azúcar, which basically just means caramel of sugarcane. But it's really good. And is it posible un poco más?
Claro.
Sí. Bueno, muchas gracias. They're very friendly here, as you can see. But I wanted to try this on camera because It's not like anything else I've ever tasted. It's not like your ordinary caramel, because it's got more of a fruity taste to it. And it's definitely got like this fresh stickiness that is like no caramel you've ever seen in your whole life. Anyways, I thought I'd share this crazy delicacy that you only find here in Ecuador. So when you come, get some for yourself. ¿Cómo te llama?
Jorge.
See Jorge, he's right across the street from the bus station, and he's got it for you. Tell him I sent you. Getting ready to go down one of the largest canopies in Ecuador. It's actually about a mile long, or it's a kilometer long, a little bit short of a mile, but it's the largest and longest canopy in Ecuador. So we're gonna go over the river, and hopefully I'll be able to tell you all about it when I get to the other side, so let's go. Rolling with the homie. Que pasa? Hollywood. I don't know where we are right now, but we just did a canopy that was crazy. And he just told me that if I want to do it again, he's going to give me a hookup on the special. So holla if you hear me. Just rolled the longest canopy in Ecuador. Here I am in the beautiful city of Baños. Come to find out that means bathroom in Spanish, but this is far from a bathroom. You can see behind me there's waterfalls coming off the Andean cliff sides, and this is probably one of the most peaceful and relaxing cities I've ever experienced. I woke up at like 5 a.m. to meet up with locals because they are known to frequent the La Piscina de la Virgin, which is known to have healing powers of some sort. Nonetheless, I enjoyed the lava heated water that was pouring off of the cliffside, and I highly recommend and encourage you to come here to Baños. It's about 4 hours outside of Quito, but it's well worth the trip. So I'll see you when you get here. Ecuador is filled with suspension bridges, all of which seem very, very unstable. But it's a part of living life, so I'm about to cross an extension bridge that is shaking in the wind. Kind of reminds me of the Golden Gate Bridge, how it shakes in the wind. Woo! Don't look down whenever you do.
As you can see, I'm standing here below one of the largest freaking waterfalls in the whole country in Ecuador. It's the one that makes you shake yourself. Woo!
After visiting the Pailon del Diablo Cascada, I was eager to venture into the town of Baños to take some captivating photos on my camera. Check out some of my shots.
People always ask me, how is it that you can afford to travel so much? My response to them is always the same. How can you afford not to? You see, life isn't about getting caught up in this rat race and some attempt to fit into the box of what society defines as successful. The true beauty of life isn't discovered through money, fame, or obtaining meaningless possessions that will deteriorate over time. The most valuable asset you could ever own are the experiences that you live and the relationships that you earn. No one can ever take away those God-given moments that are locked within the vaults of your memory banks, waiting to be relived, remembered, and reshared, sparking the flame of curiosity in others to come.
It's crazy, man. We're at the bottom of a base of a waterfall, live in the Andes Mountains. I'm happy. Can you tell I'm happy right now? Because this is what living life is all about.
Uno, dos, tres. And I will always love you.
Okay. Fishing for lunch right now. Supposedly there's some trout in here. I don't know how true that is.
Oh, see, yeah, that's money on there. That's not money on there.
So we just caught lunch.
Oh,
and it's still alive. For your lunch. Now this is what you call a fresh lunch. I'm about to make me some trout. Fry this trout up. We just caught it in the river.
Oh.
But you know. No hormones, only fresh.
Yo, what's up? Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video along with all the other videos that you've watched during my experiences and travels around the world. You've shared them with so many of your friends that I've accumulated hundreds of thousands of views, and I've actually now attracted the attention of several tourism departments. So because of you, I'm gonna have the opportunity to travel the world and record videos and document different cultures and experiences that are out there for everyone to see one day, hopefully. So thank you so much for your time. And again, subscribe right here, click that little button, subscribe, share with your friends. And I thank you so much because without you, this will not be possible.
There's a lot of people that can relate to that story, and you know, there's a movie that's 2 hours, 2.5 hours long about this subject. There's so many different emotions that's left untold because you have to fit this into a format. Like, I took a scene in which T.I., who plays Denzel's nephew, who's going to be was a pro ball scout, and Denzel had set it up for him to meet with the Yankees, and it was all set up. This guy was on his way to a legit life and be like, you know, a superstar in his own right. And T.I. didn't attend a meeting, and he asked him, why do you attend this important thing that I set up for you? He's like, I don't want to be a pitcher anymore. I don't want to be a baseball player. I want to be like you. So that emotion right there, we never got to see Denzel go to his room and cry, you know, or at least be reflective about it, because, you know, that's the last thing he wanted for his nephew. Else he went, hence, he wouldn't set up the meeting. He didn't want his nephew following him into that type of life. So those are things that I would take. I would press pause on them, and then I would explain it, you know, explain the emotions behind it.
Django. Oh, okay, what you gonna do?
So what was I saying?
That's why I was really excited about the movie, you know, because it took me back to a place that I hadn't been for a minute, you know. And, you know, it just sparked all these ideas and all these thoughts and all these emotions that, you know, that I wasn't dealing with for a while. I was over there living my life, having a great time, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, wow.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, we gotta go. Yeah. So, we're gonna
wrap it up, BlackTree TV.
Wrap it up.
And he has a BlackTree, so we gotta go.
Wrap it up. We gotta go.
That was gold right there. Yeah. I'm gonna leave that. But before we go, can I give one more question? I mean, it's been a serious thing all week, and everybody's been talking about it. Yeah. I wanna get you guys' reaction on Trayvon Martin in that case. You know, so how do y'all feel about that? I mean, none of y'all are old enough to be mothers of a 17-year-old, but... You know, just being that situation, what do y'all think about the case and how we should
proceed? Well, we're tragic. We all come from black men. You know, we have uncles and brothers and, you know, nephews. And, you know, we're sitting next to one. Anytime something happens, you know, you feel for all the men in your community and all and Latinos and the other communities it affects as well. So it's a tragic day for all of us, you know, their family. Our prayers go out to them. And we hope that this situation makes us take a deeper look so this doesn't happen again, again and again and again. And obviously it's been happening quite a bit.
Yeah, and a bigger stand at being vocal about it and bringing it like to center stage and, you know, just keep doing that because I feel like the more attention that we give it and the more that we're vocal about it, the more it absolutely cannot be ignored.
So. Well, thank you. Everybody check out Think Like a Man. Greatest movie I've seen in a long time. Aww. Funny, y'all would love it. And check out these ladies and this gentleman and whatever they got coming up next.
That's my boob. That's my boob.
That's great.
Jay, you're losing the games for us.
You're not even using the picks.
You shot 1 for 27.
I'm not the one that's not coming off the picks.
Y'all done here? We want to play some full court.
Oh, yeah. We're good.
We're not.
Y'all want the court? You play for the court. That's what real men do.
Right. So y'all
want
to play for it?
Am I stuttering? You're not going to punk us.
I'm not serious.
I am serious. People come in here and they think they got us. Y'all don't have nothing.
Aww. This spring.
Babe, I got a slap taste. I'll be right back.
I'll be right here.
Okay. Ugh, you were an animal last night. So, babe, I was thinking we could go on our first real date.
Yeah, babe, we should do that.
Alex. No, he didn't. He took my coffee.
Guys. Happy Valentine's Day, sweetie.
And you too, Mom.
I'm just gonna leave you two alone.
I'll call you.
Or not.
We'll be guys.
Sally slam. Go park some cars.
Whoa, she's so sweet to the eye. She walk right by with her nose in the sky.
That's my car. She don't even know who
I am. Okay, where's the window?
Hi. The Dark Knight strikes again.
But women have had enough.
What is the problem with men of this generation?
Ladies, till you understand the mindset of a man, you are never gonna win in the game of love.
Act like a lady, but think like a man.
Think like a man.